welcome to the espresso, your daily shot of Chinese words with Catherine Xiang. I'm Catherine Xiang. 大家好，欢迎来到我的频道 the espresso. In this channel, we explore the relationship between Chinese characters and words. 那么在这个频道呢，我向大家介绍中文里面字和词之间的关系。So this is a brand new playlist. I'm very excited to introduce that to you, where I invite fellow Chinese educators that they're going to come share their research best practice, as well as give advice to our Chinese language learners. 那么在这个名师讲坛我的新的一个、采访系列里面呢，我会邀请到我的这个同仁，同样是汉语教学里面的这些学者和名师，来介绍他们的科研，他们对汉语教学的理念，包括给我们同学一点建议。Join me today is actually my colleague, also good friend from LSE. So,Mr. Pan Fang 老师。Hi, would you like to say hi to friends of the espresso?
大家好 ,Hello everyone, I'm Pan Fang. Nice to meet you everyone.
Thank you so much for joining us today. So let me just formally introduce Pan 老师. He's currently a coordinator language teacher at LSE, London School of Economics and Political Science. He contributes to a range of different programs here at LSE,both BSc Language, Culture and Society, as well as BSc International Relations and Chinese. And prior to LSE, he worked at Harvard University, and where he actually also teach a range of different courses and won Teaching Excellence Award for consecutive years. And he got a master's from Indiana University, Birmingham, and majored in Chinese language pedagogy. In terms of his research, he's done...mainly research in video production, grammar, as well as curriculum design. He actually contributed to one of my edited book cases on audiovisual media in language education named Short Video Production for Language Learning and Assessment. It's been such a great pleasure to work with him on this project. And today I specifically wanted to invite him to talk more.And share more insights about that project. Great to have you here, Fang, and I'm gonna pass over to you. Tell us more about your video project.
Thank you, Catherine, for inviting me today. Today I will talk about the video project I'm doing, have been doing for like 5 years at LSE so far. So first I want to talk about why I thought about this project, how come I had this idea.So at the very beginning, I thought this video project could be an opportunity for students to work in a team. Because usually when they're in the classroom, they always learn by themselves. They didn't really have a chance like to work together, to study together outside of the classroom. So I think if there is a project for them, they can work together. And also it's a very creative, active and visual way to learn Mandarin. They have to produce a film, they have to...write things together to perform out. So it's very like fun way for them to learn Mandarin. Another thing is because they need to write out, like the script, they need to film something. They actually put the language use into real communication. As you know, like in daily classrooms, the questions can be very dry. It's like teacher asks something, you say something, but usually there is not much meaningful context.But through this project, they can actually say whatever they want, and they can also use all the languages into like a meaningful context. Of course, finally, I think that's a very, very good assessment way. It's not like you just let students sit in the classroom, do listening, do speaking, but actually you let them, produce something like a project, and at the end, you can assess them from different aspects, and different ways. So that's...all the reasons I had, so to put this into practice and thought about doing a project could be a good way to do it. And then the requirements for this project. So basically I could say there's no requirement because students can film whatever they want. But of course I asked them to be creative. You know, you don't just put a camera in front of you, say like things in front of camera, but I want to see you act out.You don't read from the script, you have maybe like different scenes. So actually you can feel it's a real video, a real short film, or even like a music video. Of course, the reason I want students to do this project is to learn Mandarin. That's why another requirement is saying like, please use as many grammar points, vocabularies as possible that you learn in the classroom so that you can practice, you can use. And of course, because later I'm gonna grade, I'm gonna mark, so I have a time duration requirement on this. If you are doing by yourself, maybe like 4 or 5 minutes, so I have enough sample to mark. If you are in a group, maybe like 6 or 7 minutes, so I would let students know like a suggested time frame. Then next, I want to talk about the stages. Like I divided them into 4 stages. So the first one is the pre-project. So for example, like in week 1, I tell students what this project is about. Also let them know when you need to submit your script, when you need to submit your video, and also the requirements I just talked about, I would also let students know. In the past, I also play some sample videos to students so they can have some rough ideas of like, you know, what the iFilm is about, what previous students had done, so they could learn from those sample videos. And also I would make it very clear about assessments, like the marking criteria, everything. So that's usually done in week 1. And then the rest, almost like several months, is for students, you know, to brainstorm, to team up. They would think about what they want to film, who they want to work together with, what kind of video they want to film. Can be like a short film, can be a monologue, can be like a music video. So they have to decide. And also at the same time, they're also learning, you know, Mandarin in the classroom. So they're building up their language knowledge. So that's why I give them a long period of time for them to prepare, for them to, you know, to get some ideas for this project. And then the stage 2 is called the script stage. So in week 15, students need to submit like the script to me. Can be in characters, can be in pinyin, whatever they want. But they need to use a lot of grammar points and vocabulary to write out the script. When I mark the script, I usually pay attention to the language accuracy. Of course, I would correct all those wrong grammar and wrong vocabularies. And also I would look into complexity and range to see if maybe it's deep enough, like the topic, the content. And then I would also give feedback on their roles. Like not because this, I think it's very different from the usual like essay marking, because the usual ones, you just give them, you know, a grade and all talk about language accuracy, complexity, vocabulary use. But this one, you also want to give them like some suggestions how to film it. Because in the past, I feel some students, they have very great script, but at the end, I always feel something is missing. Maybe like surprising ending, or maybe like, you know, educational like purpose or sparkling point, maybe you can point out at the end. So I also give students some feedback about how to film it, how to make the video more interesting to the audience. So that's something I do in this week. And then, of course, this is the week I mark, and then after that, I give back the script to the students, and then they can look at my correction, and then now they can start thinking about how they are gonna film it. Then comes the stage 3, so it's the video production. So for here, it's totally up to students how they want to film, like using what filming equipment. Can be like iPad, can be, you know, like their phone. Can even be, you know, like a very professional, like a video camera. For the videos, I actually tell my students they should put English subtitles on it, because at the end, I want all the classmates, all the students to watch their classmates' videos so they can do peer viewing. So, but, you know, sometimes it can be very difficult if some students use the words or sentences other students don't know, so they need to put English subtitles on it. And also the videos can be shown to other audience who has no knowledge of Chinese. And also, like I said at the beginning, I don't want them just put a camera in front of them. I want to have different scenes. So they need to make proper connections and transitions between different scenes and proper, of course, editing and maybe some special effects. I think at LSC, we have very great staff can support students for, you know, video production. In the past, some staff from the language center helped students with editing, They even organize some workshops to provide like media support. Then the next step, of course, students need to submit their videos to me. And then I will mark the students speaking in the video. When they submit me the video, they also need to submit me like a description of the work distribution among the group members. Because maybe some students, they work on, you know, editing the video. Some students helped with subtitles. Some students helped with, you know, special effects. So I would like to know how students, you know, worked together in the team. The last stage is the post-project stage. So we do peer viewing, you know, in the classroom. And also in the past, we had public screening to the entire school, to the entire, you know, like community, learning community, anyone who's interested to see those film projects. So like the audience can even vote. So later I'm gonna touch upon this more. I have some pictures to show. So basically this is the rough idea about the four stages. Next, I'm gonna talk about the marking, how I do. Actually, I already talked a little bit, but here's gonna go into the details. So first, I divide the marking into three parts. The first one is writing. So 30% goes to the script and 5% goes to the listening exercise. Script, of course, is the thing they want to talk in the video. So they write out the script, I mark. So based on the marking criteria provided by the LSE Language Center. And then the listening script, listening exercises is I don't want them just produce like a video. I also want to use their video as a listening practice material. So they write out like listening exercises, like questions. In my video, for example, in my video, did I go shopping? In my video, did I, you know, like do something A or B or C or D? So they design the listening exercises. So through designing this, they are the teacher. And then they also think from teacher's perspective. So they, in the future, when they take the listening exam, they actually know, or usually, how teacher gonna think about questions for listening exercises. So I think it's a good practice for them to think about what questions you can ask in your videos. And then other students can watch the video and also do the listening exercise. For the speaking, it's 50%, because I think the majority of, you know, the project is, of course, to act out, to speak. So that's why a large portion of the marking goes to speaking. For writing, because they work in a team, so the grade is going to be the same among the team members. But for the speaking, I mark individually on their performance in the video, so the grade is going to be individual. Students can choose to do a music video, but it's going to be very hard to mark on how well they sing. That's why if they decide to do a music video, I ask them to also upload a file of them reading out the lyrics. So I mark on their actual, you know, reading. And then the last part is the 15% goes to video production. Because students make a lot of efforts in making the video. I don't want them, you know, have no grade at all, just like when they film something. So usually I give like very considerate, very good marks to video production, as long as it's, you know, have a lot of scenes, has correct subtitles. So it's more like encourage them, you know, to do this project. So yeah, usually I tell students, you can do a storytelling video, you can do music video, you can even film a commercial. You can even do like a monologue, anything you like. And then, so this, to summarize the assessment. So the first stage is the script, mainly targeting at writing and reading skills. And then it's gonna be the video production. So it's speaking and media editing skills. Next step is the listening design. So they need to write out the listening paper. So it's also, they need to write. It's testing their writing skills and also let them to have a sense of listening skills. The final part is peer viewing, and also you watch other people's video and do their listening exercise. So it's focusing on listening and reading skills. So when I was doing this project, I also referred to other, colleagues, their works on their video production. So what I found, one of the article was written by Hafner and Miller in 2011. They also had this idea saying if you want to use technology to support language learning, like a video project can be divided into three stages. So it is exactly what I'm doing. I found it very interesting. Like the first step, you have to plan something and then you film and edit. And also they pointed out, you have to share the video. That's very important because through sharing, like people can learn from you. You can also learn from others. And also you can organize discussion in the classroom to say, what do you think of the video? What did you learn from it? So I think it's actually a very great project, can be like, approved by other colleagues in the past. Of course, I've been doing this project for almost 5 years now. So I gathered some feedback from students. So you can see the words in red are like, some positive ones. The ones in blue can be like something I still need to consider and also improve. So for most part, students think it's very fun, it's very creative, and allow them to work in a team. So they said a lot of like fun, innovative, entertaining. But for, challenging parts, the blue parts, it's of course students find it's very time consuming because they need, a lot of time to film the video. Can be a lot of efforts to put into this. So throughout the 5 years, I gathered different feedback. So at the beginning, the project maybe only replaced some of the assessments throughout the year. But because I see the effort they put into this project, and also I got the feedback saying it's time consuming. So now the iFilm project, actually it's almost like 30% of their, daily assessments. And also students say it's, some of them, they don't have any skills in, editing the videos. That's why I always invite colleagues from the Language Center to give media editing support. So I think through getting feedback from students, the project can be, nowadays, I feel like it's more smooth for students to conduct. So here is just some, materials I give to students. This is the poster I designed for students to know we have like an iFilm project. And also here you can see I'm saying everyone is a big director. 人人都是大编导, so encourage them to film it. Here is like a guideline, a short guideline for students, letting students know what I expect you to do, how I mark them, and also I provide them a suggested timeline, in which week you need to submit me the script, submit me the video. Here is the photos from the public screening. We did one in like, I think 2 years ago, like we invited students, the students who filmed the video to come to the viewing, and also we sent leaflets to all the students at LSC. We also invited colleagues at the Language Center to watch them. So this is the actual screening flyer. So where it is, what time it is. And here there are, this student actually, she produced one video, and some of the students are her friends. And some here, you can see some colleagues and some teachers also watched it. We also provided reception for it. What I think the public screening is special is, it's not just about watching the videos. At the end, the audience actually had the chance to vote for the videos they liked the best. So you can see that was one of the screening programs we had before. So after the screening, the audience directly vote. I also listed like 6 videos, let them know what videos they watched. So they could just write down on a piece of paper and say, okay, I like video 1, I like video 6. And then later we count and have a break, have a reception, and then we announce the winners. And we also award, give prizes to the students. Those winner videos could also be used to next year, because at the beginning I said, when I introduced the iFilm project, I would play some sample videos. So those sample videos could be, you know, the past winners. So students could also expect, oh, I'm not just going to film something at the end. My videos can be watched by a lot of other people. I could have the chance to win something. So that's also, you know, encourage students, you know, to participate in this project. So yeah, that's all my concepts and the content of the project.
Great, thank you so much for sharing. It's a lot to take in because I can see the project is really well designed. Like it's also step by step, and you've got so many different elements like creativity, teamwork, individual work, and language skills and editing skills. It's a such fascinating project. I just wondered, you know, you talked a little bit about your own learning, right? So I'm just thinking about for other colleagues, if they want to do something a little bit similar. So what will be your own learning through the past 5 years? And what kind of input do you think as a teacher will be most important to make this project successful?
I think for teachers, you need to actually make sure you give students enough support. Because first thing, like let's say the script. So sometimes students feel they want to say something, but they don't know how to say it in Chinese. They don't have enough language skills to put the thing they want to say into the script. So you need to guide them to let them know how to write out a good script. And also another thing I think I actually mentioned there, saying it's not just about language accuracy. You also want to give students some feedback about how to film it. I remember once some students filmed, like a commercial. They are saying Chinese learning is good. Come to learn Chinese with us. But then at the end, I was expecting they're actually, you know, it's a surprising. At the end, they would have like come to learn Chinese with us. Because the whole video is about how good they are. They are like a Chinese learning agency. And then it's kind of like a commercial thing. But towards the end, it was not very clear. They feel like it's clear to the audience, it's a commercial. But for me, I don't think so. Maybe if it's a commercial, you know, at the end, you always like phone us, that's the number, and come to learn with us. So I provided some, you know, suggestions to the video. So make it more obvious to the audience. Because sometimes students feel they know what they want to film, but the audience may not actually know what they want to tell us. Mm-hmm. So I think that's another thing the teacher can support them through the film project. Another thing is the media editing. So some students really struggled a lot, you know, adding subtitles, finding the suitable, you know, equipment to film. So I helped them to, you know, to borrow some equipment if they don't have iPad or like a phone. Also like organize the workshops for them to learn how to use like iMovie, like the app from Apple, or maybe even like some softwares like Microsoft. So they have different computer systems, they have different apps. So I think that's also very important to make the project successful. The last thing I think is teachers need to encourage them to do it, make them realize it's not just a project, and actually help them learn the language. I don't want them just feel like they consume a lot of time, but they are not actually learning. Of course they are learning, and actually it's an even better way to learn, because they need to write out something they want to say. So it's practicing their writing skills. And then later they have to memorize everything. So it's focusing more on their, you know, like speaking. Because in the video, they don't want to embarrass themselves. They want to perform well. So they actually pay a lot of attention to the tones, to the pronunciation. So it really helps them with their speaking. So I think teachers really need to let students see the whole picture, like the purpose of doing this project. And, you know, give a lot of support, give a lot of encouragement. So yeah, so I think those are very important.
I just wondered, what happened to different personalities, like different personalities of students? What if they're very shy? How can they learn through the project? If they're very shy, they think, oh, I'm not an actor or actress, I don't know what to do. How do you support them?
Yeah. That kind of thing. Throughout the years, I actually found those students who are shy, they actually wanted to do the project by themselves. Because the project actually, you know, you could work in a team or you could by yourself. So we had students, you know, they actually did the project by themselves. It turned out to be great because it can be like a monologue. I remember one year there was a student did a monologue, like it's called Mr. Beer. Later we can, I can show this video to you. It was very good. You know, he was very shy, but the video turned out to be excellent because he had this fantastic idea about, you know, this beer. So I told students, if you are shy, you can think about different video genre you can feel. You can do it by yourself. You don't need to act out, but you can do something like editing, mixing, like clips. You have like, different ideas I provided to them so that they don't have this problem. And also, at the same time, I always encourage students to work in a team. I say, now you are shy, but why don't you take this opportunity to know more people? And then through the teamwork, you can actually get to know people and, you know, to learn the language together. And maybe you find out actually you want to take more part of it. So that's another suggestion I give to students. So it depends on different people. You can do it by yourself, or I encourage them to work in a team.
Yeah, I can see. Yes, it's great to give them at least the option also to try, like you say, different style. So talking about different style, you've been working on the project for 5 years. And I think I've seen some, right? But obviously for the friends, for more audience part of the espresso, they want to see it. And maybe you tell us, you know, what will be your top three, top five? What really impressed you, surprised you? Maybe we can share some clips. Maybe first, let's just hear from you, like what kind of videos impressed you the most?
I think there are some videos actually impressed me a lot. So one video is from one of our certificate students. She actually majored in media and communications. So one thing the video impressed me a lot is it was almost like a professional like shoot video, like all the transitions. Yeah, the quality is so okay. Good. And also the speaking and pronunciation was also good. And it was kind of like also a surprising ending. So everyone laughed. I remember that video won like the best video of that year. The second video is the one I just mentioned, like the Mist Beer. It was very special because the student was shy. He didn't show much of himself in the video, but he still, of course, spoke a lot. And also the story was based on through the eyes of the bear. So it was a very unique perspective, unique like a video. Other videos, I remember some degree students, they filmed like Xiao Hong Mao. They also filmed like some music videos, like they changed the like the Mulan theme song, like Hao Han to like learning Chinese. So they wrote out their own lyrics, their own song. So it's really fun to watch because they filmed, you know, like at different parts at LSE, so you could actually got to know the school. And also they had a lot of funny actions in the video. But of course, you know, students are not professional singers, but you can still see their efforts, you know, in making the video. And also like the Xiao Hong Mao, the students, you know, they went to on the street to film. They did go to different shops. They had different scenes to actually make this happen. So it's really fun. Another thing I think, if you watch some of the videos, you can find a lot of students filmed about love. Because I think in level one, when they learn Chinese with me, you know, in class, sometimes I... when they learn the new words, I talk about like how to say love at first sight, how to say break up, because when they learn love, I say, oh, well, I no longer like you, 我不喜欢你了. So they pick up a lot of those words into their production. So you can see a lot of iFilm videos are about love. So I remember another video is about, you know, one girl and one boy. The girl really likes the boy, but the boy doesn't have money. So he thought the girl wouldn't like her, and then he overheard the girl said something to her mom about being poor. So the guy was very sad, but it turned out to be the The girl said, "I don't mind, he's poor, I still like him." So then later it was like a happy, you know, ending, like they got together. So there are some great ideas from students. I think those videos are the most impressed videos for me. Yeah.
Great. I think now the audience probably want to at least watch one or two. So let's take a look. We'll follow your suggestion and watch a few short videos. And for the rest, if there's more, we can put it into the description so people can have a look as well.
你好吗？请别站起来，我真的不想浪费你的时间。你现在听不懂我说的话时间。在全球，人们会说很多的语言，他们会说英文、中文、西班牙文、斯瓦希里语等等，但是我要说的话是娃娃语。我叫熊先生，我是大卫的泰迪熊。人们笑的时候，我们那就是他们的朋友，又是他们的保护者。我们一起聊天、玩游戏、去很远地方等等，我们真的是他们的监护人。最近会开始，我就会称呼他的大妈。大卫真的是个很好的小孩子，因为大卫没有兄弟姐妹，所以我们是很密切。我们常常交谈，我们也常常看电影。我们最喜欢的是速小说。我们开玩笑，我们也很少吵架。很久很久以前，我们是好朋友。之后，我觉得他把我丢倒了，可是我不是乐事，我不想死了，我需要生活。
我的大妈在哪儿？
所以我不会住在这里。我真的爱大卫，他是我的兄弟，但是他不记得我。我的兄弟不死了，但是他在一个遥远的地方。需要离开。我很想坐公共汽车去看我的父母，他们住在曼彻斯特。可是因为我现在没有钱，所以我不能出。泰迪熊常常没有钱，所以不能坐公共汽车。虽然你忘记我，但是我真的爱你。即使你我之间没交天，我暂时是你的监护人。我就要死了，我想跳。大卫，再见。但是我不能死了，因为我是一个泰迪熊。
你好，小易，你怎么样？
不错，你了？
很累，学习太忙了，可是我还要洗衣服。
C'est la vie。
对了，有一些洗衣机坏了，你知道是哪一个吗？
不知道哎。
6号和8号坏了，不要用。
哦，谢谢你，我会用9号和10号。我叫客人，你叫什么？
我叫杰森。
很高兴认识你，他是我的朋友小易。
很高兴认识你们，你们是哪里人？
我是韩国人。
我是香港人。你了？
是马来西亚人。你们在哪里念书？
我在 LC 学习传媒。
我在 LC 学习法律。
你呢？
我在 UCL 念计算机科学。
小易，你有英镑吗？
有。
可以借我吗？
不行。当然可以啦。
谢谢。
眉头解不开的结，命中解不开的结，是你。
太棒了！
谢谢。
你弹钢琴有多久了？
我从小妈妈就教我钢琴，可是因为我练习的很少，所以弹的不怎么样。
你妈妈是钢琴家吗？
是啊。
你爸爸呢？
啊，我爸是个经济学家。那你们的父母呢？
我的妈妈和爸爸都是老师。小易，你父母做什么工作？
我爸爸是一个医生，我妈妈是个家庭主妇。你们有兄弟姐妹吗？
我有一个哥哥。那你们呢？
我有一个姐姐。
我没有兄弟姐妹。你最近在学钢琴吗？
对啊，我最近有在和我的朋友学钢琴。
我像我喜欢上一个人了。
那你约他出去啊。
可是我怎么约他？
约他一起去看电影啊。赫尔人，你可以的。
好的，我会约他。可是你一起来，要不然我会觉得很奇怪。
好的，我会一起来的。
谢谢。
你最喜欢哪一个作曲家？
这个我觉
得。哦，是谢剑。
你好，杰森，你想跟我和小一看电影吗？
好啊，你想什么时候看？
星期五晚上7:30可以吗？
星期五我有点忙，可能不行。
星期六晚上可以吗？
星期六，好啊，不见不散。
你要薯片吗？
好啊，谢谢。
Thank you so much for sharing the video project. It's super, super impressive from your perspective as well as students' performance. So it's really, really fun. I just thought we end with a kind of general question. So if you were going to give 3 top advice to our students, 3 top tips, what would be your advice to any Chinese learners?
My tips for Chinese learners can be summarized as 3 H's. The first one is have faith. So Chinese is indeed difficult. So if you want to learn it well, you need to have confidence. You need to believe in yourself. So I think it's very important that everyone should have faith. The second one I would say is have patience, because it takes time to master a language and you need to keep practicing every day with your friends, with your teachers. Also, you need to read books. So it takes a lot of effort. So definitely have patience. Lastly, I think you should have fun, because one can only learn the language well if he enjoys it. So, for example, you can find your own fun way to learn the language, like doing some fun vocabulary games. You can also, explore many fun things about China, like the culture, the society. All those can help you enjoy learning the language. Those are my tips for the Chinese learners. Thank you.
Thank you so much for sharing those with us. And thanks everybody for watching today's interview. Hopefully you will enjoy today's interview, but also enjoy students' little video as well. So see you next time. Bye.